maybe about a year since we last QSO'd. Hey, Roger there, Dan. Well, you got a good sound and signal here. 7 and 9, 7 and 9, and very nice audio. How's the how's everything out there? How's the weather, Dan? So it's a wet day in Maine. Well, I'll tell you what there, Dan. We got, I'll tell you what it's doing here. It's about 43 degrees Fahrenheit here on our island today. And scattered clouds and sunshine. And a green Christmas for us again. It's not often we get a white Christmas up here in the islands. But yeah, no, it's been good. It's all been good. And we had a great Christmas here. And I hope you guys had a great Christmas up there too. And sounds like you had a very balmy Christmas. 50 degrees is nice on Christmas Day. I'm the same way. I don't need anything, you know. I give a few gifts here and there. I really don't need anything myself. It's all about being with family.
Well, you know, if somebody offered me a new Kenwood or a new Yaesu, I probably wouldn't turn it down.
I'm probably the same way. I like one of those. That'd be nice. I don't know what you're running for equipment there, but it sounds really good. And it is Joe on this side, Juliet Oscar Echo. I'm running an RCI 2980WX, D104 and an Antron. Nice beam, yeah, good radio too. Yaesus are great, one of my favorites. I have a 2970DX as well, which is a neat little radio, but this is kind of my Christmas present to myself. I bought this one a month ago, brand new, and it seems to be working okay. I appreciate that because I had a bit of trouble. I wired a new microphone plug on this thing, and it was cutting in and out before and give me a bit of static, so I finally got it wired properly. And yeah, so far the audio, you know, I'm getting radio checks. It seems to be okay. I have the microphone, the D104, turned quite a ways down, and I'm just using the mic gain on the radio. I got it set at about 7 or 8. Oh, I appreciate that there. That's a very interesting tip about the microphone there. Yeah, I didn't know that. And I know they pick up a lot of background noise, these D104s. They're very, very powerfully amplified microphones. So, like I say, I have this microphone turned quite a ways down. Now, that 2995DX you had there, that's a pretty powerful radio. That puts out about 150 watts. Oh yeah, yeah, I've worked a few stations running those and they're really, really nice radios. This 2980WX base here, it's only 25 watts, but I do have a little help on the side here. I have a Texas Star High Drive amp and I got it just pushing about 80 right now. I got it turned down, so we're running 80 to about 100. That is really interesting, Dave. I did not know that. But you know what? I have seen the old the microphones with, like you say, a piece of foam over it that the broadcasters, and I didn't even know why they did that. That's very interesting. Yeah, no, I know what you mean. I've had that happen before where somebody thinks you know, they can hear the background noise. They can hear the dog barking, or my bird I had was making a bunch of noise, or somebody talking in the background, because they do pick up a lot. So I'm gonna have to try the old try the kid's mitten on that crystal. That is very, very interesting. I've been running D104s for just about 40 years now, and I had no idea, so I learned something new every day. Yeah, but we have fun doing it too. It's a good hobby, and you meet a lot of people, and it is very enjoyable. Oh, that's interesting. Wow, very, very interesting. I did not know that either. And this has a pretty good speaker on in this RCI 2980WX. I have an external one hooked up to my 2970DX here. But yeah, very good tips here, Dave. That's amazing. That is amazing. That is just awesome. Well, that's a good tip, man. I, you know, I totally appreciate it. And you know, like I say, you learn something new every day. And talking to people like you on here, it's you're very like a fountain of information. I appreciate that. You've probably been into radio a long time. I got into it in 77, so 37 years here. I'm 50 years old here, so yeah, well, I don't think you're not, probably not that much older than me, but and time does fly. I was born in 64, put it that way. Is that right, eh? Okay, so you might have about maybe about 15 years on me, 10, 15 years. Hey, Roger, on that there. Well, you got some good good advice there. I got my first radio in 1977. I actually still have it, and that's when I got my first license when I was 13 years old. And before that, I had just one of these receivers I could listen to 11-meter band in 1976 when it was really big. It was really big, and I says it was fun listening to those guys, but it'd be a lot more fun if I could talk to them. So my parents bought me a radio. I remember I used to go to them. God, people used to even send out QSL cards. And you know, the funny thing is, A guy the other day asked me if I sent out QSL cards. I have not sent out a QSL card in years, and I used to. It was like 70s and 80s and even into the early 90s. You know, a lot of QSL cards, and I thought it was a thing of the past. This guy actually asked me if I would, because he did. So I sent him one to New York the other day. No. I just put when I talked to him, confirmed the QSO, you know, his signal he was coming in, the day we talked, the frequency, the mode, what I'm running, and my address, his address, and I shipped it off to him in an envelope with another one, and that was it. Yeah, no QSL manager needed. I remember that back in the day, you know that? And I have a big box of QSL cards. I used to go out to the mailbox pretty much every day. I'd get them when I was a kid, you know, because I used to send out a lot of them. And it was fun. And I still have them in a big box. I mean, you're probably the same way. I got a big Apple box full of them in the same envelopes I got them. And I just used a letter opener to open up those envelopes. And they're still even in the original envelopes. That is pretty interesting, isn't it? And meeting people off here. I mean, over the years, like you say, we've met a lot of people off here. And you know, people coming over to help with antennas. I've had that. I had one guy actually make me an antenna when I was a kid, a two-element V-quad. I totally agree with you. Yeah, nope, that's, I think, a thing of the past there, Dave. I totally remember that. I remember putting up a tower one time. This would have been around 1980. A 30-foot tower, 6-foot of mast, and I had a two-element eliminator, two high-gain beam I put all together. But I needed people to help me. They were there. Whole mess of people to help me put that tower up. I agree with you. You know, and I enjoy talking DX. And you know, that's kind of one of the reasons I actually got an 11-meter radio. When I got that receiver back in 1976, Dad and I used to listen to it, and I could hear all the skip coming in. I didn't know much about it back then, but I thought, boy, it'd be fun to talk to those guys. So Mom and Dad took me to Radio Shack. I got an old TRC 452. It was probably the first 40 channels that came out there. It didn't have a digital channel selector, just little black numbers with a light behind it. Hooked it up with a Radio Shack half-wave ground plane and the stock microphone. And I remember talking to a guy in Louisiana. I got my first QSL card. That would have been in 77. I still have that. And I've always talked DX. I talk locals too at night, but mostly it was for the DX. Beam and holy mackerel, you know, you It's amazing, yeah. And I remember those radios too. I remember even talking to people on them, and the old Browning Golden Eagles. I remember the DAC radios, all that old stuff back in the day there. But those are days gone by. You can buy some of that stuff on eBay now. Some of those old 6 or 8 channel radios, whatever they are, with tubes in them. Oh, I know. Yeah, I know those radios for sure. And definitely talk to people with those things. Not a lot of those around anymore. And then, of course, the upper frequencies. I put the upper frequencies in 1980. I got them installed in my old 458. And not a lot of people seemed to have those back then. That was a lot of fun. Great radio.
Yeah, I have the old FT DX401 tube type one. Still have it. But don't fire that up anymore. That's an old fire.
I had a 101B, and then I found a 101 double E that was in pretty good shape. And I ran that double E for a long, long time.
Yeah, there's still a few operators.
I love those radios, the old Yaesus. Yep, there was a few people on our island that used to run those old FT-101E's. Beautiful radio. Oh yeah, I bet, eh? I bet. You know, and come to think of it, actually, I also, my first high frequency was an old TRC-48 23 channel Radio Shack sideband radio with I still have it, with a Siltronics Model 90 variable frequency oscillator I plug into it. I know that one too. Yeah, I've never owned it, but I definitely know that radio. And they were, I've talked to people on them back in the day. Don't really hear much about those anymore. That is really cool. And you can find that stuff on eBay, because I'm always looking at eBay. I like looking at the radios. I still run my old TRC-458. I bought new in February 1978. It's sitting here right beside me with a D-104 on it, and it still works like a charm. That the problem with me, I keep everything, right? And I just kind of stash it away. So I have everything I've ever had, except all my old antennas. That's one thing I wish I would have kept, some of my old antennas. So right now we're just running an Antron, and I've had this one up since 93, and so far so good. It seems to be working okay.
Thank you.
Oh, yeah, right on. And I know those beams, too, the tri-banders. You're going to probably need a Ham 3 rotor, heavy-duty rotor for that one. Yeah, that's what you got to watch, I guess, too. And some people have to watch wind, also the wind speed where they live. Some people get high winds, and it's pretty tough on the antennas. Lady down the road from here, and she's been into radio a long time. She's got a 50-foot freestanding tower with the old Wilson shooting star up there.
Boy, I haven't seen one of those in a while.
Yeah, it's beautiful. She's just probably about a mile and a half south of me. She's rarely ever on the radio anymore, but she's had that thing up there for 25 years easily or more, but still works. That's right, Dan. Yeah, I agree with you. So and a lot of people get out of it too. They kind of get bored of it, and they sell everything, and that's it. But I've never done that. I've always hung on to my stuff, and it's something I've just always enjoyed to do, especially on a rainy day. I really love it on a winter day when it's kind of miserable weather, and you're sitting in this nice warm radio room chit-chatting all over the world. You want to know the funny thing is, I've never even owned a cell phone in my life. I have one at work through the company I work for. I work for the Parks Department here, and that's the only cell phone I have. And when I go home after work, the cell phone stays in my parks truck. Well, I tell you what, right now conditions are amazing because you're hitting me up into the red. You're the only station on frequency as to speak of. I do hear another station on the side there, but it is dead quiet. The frequency is quiet. You do sound like a local station. Very interesting. And so do you have your beam pointed right towards me then, towards the Pacific Northwest?
I am right now, 17 degrees west of magnetic north. I'm pretty much going right over the pole down to you guys, and toward the pole, you guys. So I'm taking the upper path.
Oh, very interesting. Okay, and I'm looking at the meter here. You're hitting me up 20 plus into the red there. My exact latitude here is 48 degrees north latitude, and our island is about 100 miles north of Seattle as the crow flies out here in the ocean. No, you're up into the red. Pretty much every time you key up, you are into the red. And are you on flat side?
I'm on the flat side right now.
That's 20 over right there.
Yeah, we've got a station on the side. Go ahead.
Yeah, just me.
he's coming in loud like you too. He's 20 plus. Wow, amazing. I love QSOs like this.
But you know, it's a pretty good shot from here to Winnipeg, never mind out to your QTH.
Well, Winnipeg's quite a ways from me too. I'm just about as far southwest as you can get. I'm close to, I'm tucked up against the very southern part of Vancouver Island here. Oh yeah, I mean Winnipeg's that's sort of the, well, I'm not going to say the center of the country, but it's getting out there. Yeah, we get Alaska here too. Alaska, we usually get every day they come in. That's the most southern part of Alaska is probably about, I'm going to guess about 700 miles north of here. I think I've talked to him, yeah, for sure. And I've actually been up to Alaska a few times. I was up there in 2012, the last time. We take the cruises up there from Vancouver. I love it. I'm going to go next summer again. I love Alaska. It's beautiful. So we just go to Vancouver, hop on the cruise ship, and away we go. And it's 1 week of fun and eating. Sounds like the Griswold Chevy Chase's vacation. Right on, and you made it okay.
Pretty much the same way, you know. It worked out pretty good, but that was back in the days when 90% of the Alcan was gravel.
I think they probably have that paved now. The most southern part of Alaska, the Panhandle, comes down near Prince Rupert in British Columbia, so I've been as far up as Skagway up in the northern end of the Panhandle. It really is, and the scenery is actually much like here. It looks the same as coastal British Columbia all the way up. I mean, where I live here on this island, it's all coniferous and broadleaf evergreen forest. It's green all the way up. Yep, been there many times. I know where Eugene is. Portland, Oregon is a 6-hour drive. Once we take the ferry over to the mainland, it's a 6-hour drive south to Portland. And Eugene's a bit south of that still.
Yeah, like I said, I've got a little splatter coming in from South America on the high, actually on the low side of this frequency.
Okay, well, you know what? I should maybe pass the numbers. I've been tying it up a while there, and hey, it's been a real pleasure to chat with you. That's a very good tip, Dan. I totally appreciate it. And hey, we're going to give it a try. Awesome. Very good advice, man. I totally appreciate it. And we're going to be listening for you again out there for sure. I know we talked to you before. It's probably, I'm guessing, about a year ago. I'd have to look in my logbook. And I do have you again in the logbook once again for the 28th of December. It's 2014. And that's Alpha Uniform 299. And I'm 9 Alpha Uniform 791. Seventy-threes to you, man. Been a pleasure. and we'll be looking for you again on the frequency here. All the best for 2015. Happy New Year to you and yours, and we'll be making that contact again. This is 9 Alpha Uniform 791, saying cheers to Alpha Uniform 299 Bangor, Maine. 7-3s, man.
7-3s, man. 9 Alpha Uniform 291. Alpha Uniform 299. All the best.
Cheers to you. 791 QSX.